So let's look at a short example of this. So here's the minimum function that we saw before. So let's assume that X is being stored in EDI and that Y is being stored in ESI. We'll see next time that this is a reasonable assumption, but for now we'll just make that assumption. So we have the min function, which begins at this label here. We need to do this comparison here. So here we're kind of comparing X with Y, but remember that when we encode this, we need to sort of encode it in reverse. So this is Y and this is X. So this is this comparison part right here. So this is comparing X with Y, right? And then if X is greater than or equal to Y, then we want to jump. And note that this is the opposite condition as this one. And this is because if X is less than Y, we want to execute this portion where we take X and we save it in the return register, which we haven't seen that part yet, but we'll see it next time. And then if X is less than Y, which means that this condition is not true, then we will execute this part. So if that didn't all make sense right away, that's okay, but I hope that you rewatch the video a couple times until you are convinced that this works and that this is the appropriate translation of this C code on the left-hand side into the assembly code on the right-hand side. This is the sort of thing that we'll expect you to be able to do. In order to do these translations, it helps to go through an intermediate step. You'll get better at them the more you do, but there are also some general tips for doing this translation. So in your textbook, they introduce this concept called go-to code. And the idea here is that we want kind of an intermediate between the regular block structured C code and the raw assembly code that we convert it to. And so we can simulate these conditional jumps in C using something called a go-to statement. So the general template here is that we'll say, you know, if some condition is true, go to a label. And it turns out that C actually has the go-to instruction and it has labels just like assembly. We haven't used them yet, but it turns out that it actually has them. And so your textbook defines this go-to code thing as being code that only uses if go-to and go-to. So there are no blocks anymore. In general, this is not a good idea at all. And there's sort of this classical discussion about the dangers of go-to code. But it is useful in this context for teaching purposes because it does get you a little closer to assembly without, while still remaining valid C code. So for instance, here's some code that looks similar to the example that we just saw. And here is that code translated into similar C go-to code. So we've reversed the conditional. So we've said if X is greater than or equal to Y, we'll skip over the body of this structure here. That means we'll go down to here. Otherwise, if X was less than Y, we'll execute that A print. We need to skip over the B part, right? So we'll have an unconditional go to at the end of this. And then at the end of the B part, we'll just fall through to C. So again, if it's not sort of immediately apparent why this is equivalent to this, then I would I'd encourage you to sort of sit there and think through it until you can convince yourself that this is valid. And then hopefully at this point it's easier to see that this can be translated into assembly much easier than this can, because this is simply going to be a comparison and a conditional jump, and then this is going to be an unconditional jump and then labels. We can also do this for loops, right? So we can translate a loop and it'll look like this.